Couple comments I want to make about what I said this morning at Mass Inc. As many of you know, Mass Inc. rolled out a report this past week, which discussed potential funding opportunities, both payroll tax and a regional fee approach, a tax approach. There were three comments that I made that Lieutenant Governor Murray spoke first and talked about the investment, the historic investment that the Patrick Murray administration has made with your help across the Commonwealth, whether it be in our accelerated bridge program, some of the interesting things we've been doing at the MBTA, whether it be the where's your bus, there's another one, where's the bus with all sorts of, I think it's probably a swear word, but in any event, you know, that's certainly those kind of programs and those kind of efforts have been critically important for us. But three things I mentioned when it comes to discussing about the challenges that we face together. First is the governor, lieutenant governor, and members of the legislature have called for an adult conversation about the need for resources and revenues. What I'm telling my team right now, and what Jeff Mullen, my predecessor, is working on as well, is deserving of that conversation. I firmly believe that it is our top job as planners, as municipal officials, as folks in transportation, that we need to convey to the public that we deserve this conversation. What does that mean? First, it means more transparency in what we're doing, whether it be around issues with the Big Dig, or coming out, which we will be next month, which is having quarterly accountability meetings. We will be having meetings like this for the public to come and see how we're doing on our performance metrics, on-time performance at the T, wait times at the RMV, pavement quality at highway. So folks know what we're doing well, what we're not doing well, and why and how we can address that. So transparency is key to that, deserving that conversation. I think the second thing that is deserving the conversation is making reform more touchable, feelable, and visible to the average customer. Again, many of you in the room have been following the reform for the last 2 years, 2.5 years. But you follow transportation, you love transportation. You are the converted. I need to talk to our customers and let them know why we need more additional resources and potential revenues to make our case. So making reform more touchable, visible, feelable. What does that mean? It means an electronic tolling pilot potentially in the next 12 months. It means having the RMV allow folks who are 65 and older who are getting elderly passes at the MBTA to come in and do that transaction at the RMV. It means real-time traffic information. I think we did a very good job of getting real-time traffic information out during our Fast 14, but that was the exception, not the rule. It should be the rule on how we're handling it. So making it more visible to the average customer, we are improving their experience through reform and letting them know that nonetheless, reform, unfortunately, is not enough to get where we want to go. Two, why now? Why the conversation now? Well, I think there are a few reasons why. First, we are not investing, and you know this very well, we are not investing in transportation for transportation's sake. We are investing in transportation because it is an economic engine of the Commonwealth. Things like Assembly Square Station, which we will be building, that is going to be an anchor for a significant development in the city of Somerville. The Green Line extension, yes, we are legally required to do it, but in of itself, it's not only a good transportation project, it is about economic development, primarily. There are other options and opportunities throughout the Commonwealth where, again, it is not transportation, but Mayor Racino's here. We are building a new parking garage at Wonderland Station, not to have cars, but what the development that it will bring around the Wonderland T station. That is what we need to be articulating. It's jobs for today, and it's jobs for tomorrow. The federal government, with due respect, are any federal partners here in the room? Are there any press in the room? Should ask that question already. I was going to say the same thing, don't worry. Unfortunately, I think the federal government is taking a step back from its transportation goals. For the first time in almost 60 years, we are seeing a growing crescendo in the Congress about taking a step back from federal funds. And if that is the case, if we are underfunded today, and the federal government begins to take steps back away from what I would argue is the obligations that they signed up for, we are in serious trouble. So having this conversation now is critically important. And finally, and I think it most acutely, is the MBTA's needs. All of you in the room know, and if you don't, then you haven't been reading the paper, but we've been trying very hard to articulate that the MBTA's budget deficit for next year is $161 million. To give you a flavor for what that means, if we were to increase fares by 25 or 30%, we would only cover half of that operating deficit, $80 million. We have to find it from somewhere else. And we shouldn't be doing it on the backs of our riders through service cuts or fare increases. That is a key piece for us. Finally, I mentioned regionalism. The report within the MassDOT discussion talks about the opportunities for a regionally based approach. I said that there were challenges and opportunities there. First of the challenges, As you all know, Massachusetts, the Commonwealth, does not have a long history of regional governance. Our county structure is generally weak. We are a system of government of cities and towns, largely, as opposed to counties. So, but obviously with the planning council and other planning councils, there is a regional base, but I think that is a challenge to convince folks that that may be a way to fund future projects. However, there's opportunity as well. As general manager of the T, I also have the pleasure and privilege of being the rail and transit administrator, working with the 15 regional transit authorities across the Commonwealth. One of my favorite complaints from customers at the T was that they wanted more of us. They wanted us to run more service. They wanted us to run later at night. They wanted more of us. And that's great, but if you take a bus in Berkshire County and you're waiting at the bus stop at Friday at 6 o'clock, you'll be waiting there on Monday morning at 6 a.m. because there is no service on the weekend. And if you rely on public transportation in Berkshires, on the Cape, in Worcester, Lowell, and you need to get that to school, home, hospital, you'll be waiting for several hours, or in the case of the Berkshires, 2 days to get public transportation. There's an equity issue that we need to talk about as well.